do we got today, boy. Look like a hurricane coming through. You see that shit before it hit the ground. Look at that poor bike. Getting wetter. Boy, look at this rain. Of course, y'all know it ain't no vlog on no bikes today. Just the beginning. So I'm starting to believe we won't be riding. As soon as this hurricane over, we'll be riding. I got time for them, my arm is feeling better. So just when we ready to ride, Hurricane Ida won't make landfall. So of course we're not gonna be riding. So tonight is just rain and wind. Not too much on that. Not too much on that place.
Wait.
I'm gonna let y'all know, update y'all when it get a little bit worse. Dead.
Look at the weather we got today, boy. Look like a hurricane coming through. You see that shit before it hit the ground. Look at that poor bike. Getting wetter. Boy, look at this rain. Of course, y'all know it ain't no vlog on no bikes today. Even though my arm still fucked up. I just wanted y'all to see how bad it's raining today. Crazy.
No shock there. Now on Monday, because we may have some tails, some bands that are lingering, we're still in a level 3 flood risk on Monday. That would be a little less widespread. This is the high resolution model we started looking at last night. And the scale goes up to 25 inches. Now, thank goodness it's not showing 25 inches, but it is showing in green. You see all the areas in green? That's 5 to 10 inches of rain. And so in my head, whenever I see a model that paints 5 to 10 inches of rain over such a widespread area, and then you've got these pockets of 10 to 15 in here, and there's 15 to 20, that's telling me that it might even be higher than this. But as we know, 5 to 10, that's going to be bad enough. We know we're going to have to expect some flooding. So the headline at this hour, Hurricane Ida, eyewall wind warning has been issued for the coastal parishes as winds of 115 miles per hour begin to approach the coastline as Ida continues to move in from the north, from the south, John.
David, that's a lot of information. Thank you. I want to get on to something else here real quickly and to make sure that we have time to get back to you at the top of the hour. But one quick question. Do you happen to know off the top of your head, I've been meaning to ask, how wide the eye wall is?
It has shrunk considerably. It was almost 30 miles wide yesterday. Now I think it's around 10.
And what's the significance of that? Obviously, the
wind.
Well,
it's indicating a much stronger storm, although big hurricanes can have larger eyes. And it's also saying that you're not going to get much of a break when that eye moves through because it is so small. I was trying to get back over to our Viper tornado detection here real quick. Let me see if we can. Yeah, here we go. I just can't see where I am to plot it. I might get Zach Zach, are you over there? Yeah, let's go ahead and plot this one more time, John. It's pretty dramatic. So again, there is the eye right now, and that is so strong, it's off our color table. But maybe just plot a number on 142 miles per hour, and then probably somewhere in here we're getting around 120 or maybe 115. Right, so the strongest side on the east side, but nothing to sneeze at on the west side. So very violent winds, now just a few miles off the coast. Obviously, hurricane conditions occurring now in Lower Plaquemines Parish. You can see radar estimates on tornado detection showing between 90 and 120 miles per hour at the mouth of the river.
So you, just so I understand, you can use your tornado detection model, your Viper model, to estimate the winds?
Absolutely, because typically when we're using this, we're using it to analyze like a small supercell storm that might be producing tornadic winds. And so, you know, we always say, oh, look, there are the greens and the reds together indicating a circulation. That means we have a twist and likely a tornado. Basically, we're analyzing a gigantic tornado now. So we're using it the same way, even though it does say Viper tornado detection. These measurements are a little bit off the surface, but again, they verify with what the hurricane hunters are finding and estimating the winds to be with Ida.
All right. Well, thank you so much, David. And we'll, of course, get back with you to get another update in just a few moments. Right now, I believe you want to check in with Meg Gatto. She's on standby to get another update for us.
All right. Thanks, Kelsey and John. We want to check in now with Michael Vincenzo. He's the
spokesperson. Power lines in that area, too. A lot of folks without power running up there near the campus of Louisiana State University. It's tough to see. It's tough to see things like that because that just shows you how vast this storm was and how far reaching with those impact winds. I mean, you're talking about 60 to 70 to 80 miles away from here in the downtown Central Business District area of New Orleans, and as far down south as our coast, as that Hurricane Ida just continued to just really ravage South Louisiana for a very huge stretch of miles.
Yeah, and then check out, I want to show you some damage in just a moment of Livingston Parish. Livingston Parish damage after we finished here with LSU here. This is James Chapel Road, also a Hammock Road in Livingston Parish after we, again, get through all of those LSU pictures there. But there's those images for you out of Livingston right now with, again, you know, the bulk of this storm really moving in that northerly direction with Livingston there getting a good bit of rain fog, a lot of trees that are down in that neck of the woods as well. So seeing those similar impacts really across the North Shore from Livingston Parish to Tange Po, even portions of St. Tammany, again, with so many down trees and so many people stuck. Maybe it's a good thing that you're stuck in a lot of ways. You really shouldn't be driving, but again, stuck on your homes because your roads are blocked. You know, it's very reminiscent of kind of like back during Katrina, whenever, you know, you could hear the roar of those chainsaws, you know, the day or two after the storm cleared, with people helping each other try and clear those roads, waiting for those energy trucks and utility vehicles to come in and help to restore power.
You know, even with the sun now up here in South Louisiana, now is not the time to get outside. We're all eager to learn more information. And I know many of our family and friends, they just want to find out if they did evacuate, what's the status of their home? You know, how soon can they get back? How soon can they rebuild? But at the same time, when your power's out and you know it's going to be out and sustained outages for days, if not weeks, depending on where you live, you just don't want to be in that position. So if you can still shelter in place safely elsewhere, that's the message from local leaders, parish leaders, even from the top of the state, Governor John Bel Edwards. A very busy response day for him and his team, and of course he's going to be taking tours of the region affected, helicopter tours that he mentioned yesterday. In just a few moments we'll hear from the governor. He'll be doing some live interviews with some of our partners at MSNBC as well. We'll try to take a live listen in, but we know that it's going to be a coordinated response.
Thank you very much, Stephanie. There's an awful lot of debris, power lines, trees on roadways, and in some places standing water. And so it's taken a while to get into these communities that were hardest hit. But we will obviously be developing the situation throughout the day, saving lives, rescuing people everywhere that we can. And we have a very robust effort underway. But that one confirmed death in Ascension Parish, we know is just the first one that we will unfortunately confirm throughout the day.
In the house, chilling, watching the corner. The wire, sorry. Riding out the hurricane, you dig? Waiting on it to clear up, but right now I'm just chilling. But Scooter, I make sure y'all tune in because we're going to be riding soon. And I'm going to let y'all know the updates on the storm. Y'all stay tuned. Already starting to flood by the bike. I don't know. We just chilling in the weather, just observing stuff. That's all. Been a single person out here. Look all down there. Nobody out, just me. The bike screaming. I got to turn that alarm off. That's gonna waste my battery. Yeah, my battery gonna die if I don't turn that shit off. And look at the shingles over there. It's hippity hop. You see them? It's crazy, y'all. We've been enjoying this weather. It's a little cooler than normal, so I'm appreciating it. Can't wait to get back on the bike, though, y'all. Can't wait. Yeah, let's take a look at the platform. It's crazy, right? You got fucking heavy rain and wind. Look at the clouds, the sky. 16 years ago today, I was in Katrina. And I'm back again with my stupid ass. I'm just enjoying this breeze before it get too hectic. That's all. Just enjoying the breeze before it get too hectic. Gray as fuck out here though. Hella gray. Look at the trees. Oh, my bike going off from the wind. I hope it don't take my bike away. I got it locked up to the pole right here. If you can see. A little lock right there, going through the wheel. So it should be secure. But look at this guy now, rain and wind. Trees ain't keeping still. It's crazy. Yeah, I ain't do nothing to the bike life. I just checked on my bike and made sure that it was locked up because of this wind. Cleaned out my ice box, and now I'm just enjoying this nice breeze. I can't wait to this shit over with so I can ride again. If y'all can't hear me, that's because of the noise of the hurricane. Getting heavy out here, y'all. Other than that, ain't nobody else out here. Like I said, it just feels good out here. I'm just chilling, that's all. But I'm gonna update y'all on it. If it get worse or if it get better, just stay tuned, you dig? Hurricane edition. All right, y'all. 2021. Not so much rain and wind this time, but I'm gonna see y'all in a minute on the update. Just, you know, chilling. Seeing who all out here. Got one person out here. That's it. Y'all watching this family, the dude Deacon put the Jasmine Diamond thing, Kaz and Mill, all y'all, Bree, Muffin, Tuncher. I'm safe, y'all. I'm just enjoying the breeze. As you can see, I live on the top level. So so I'm pretty much good. Just enjoying a little breeze. That's all. Can't wait to ride again, y'all. I'm gonna make sure to film the next day effects to let y'all see how it looks. And today is the 16th year anniversary of Katrina, and I'm sitting in the middle of Ida. 16 years later. I just talked to my mom and told her that. That's crazy. 16 years ago, I was in Hurricane Katrina, and I'm in Hurricane Ida. So that's why we ain't doing no video today, school the game. It's Hurricane Ida, man. Let's look down. This is the hurricane, y'all. See it? See all the trees? Look at the trees blowing. Look at the rain. Crazy down here. Hope everybody staying safe. Out here to get some footage. Look how great this clouds is. I'm gonna try to see it. And the wind's heavy as shit out here. Just taking a walk. It's like scooter like going on. It's hella windy out here. That's all I got. Let y'all see coming back. Hold on. Trash cans everywhere, all over. Look, trash can all over. Got a few trees, little things. Put a little fence knock down. Let's see what's over here. Look at the rain. My bike's still cool. Still blowing. They say we're not gonna stop getting wind till Thursday. Bike still protected. But yeah, y'all, it's wet as hell. Wind still blowing, but not as bad as yesterday. down. So I had to pull that fence up. And we got this little grass debris, nothing serious. We got people outside. Trash cans everywhere. Wind still blowing. Substitute again. It's the day after Ida. Everything's kind of back to normal. As far as my physical therapy is back on, so that's where I'm at right now. Hurricane didn't really do nothing to us. Our internet is off, so by the time I post this, you know what I mean? It'll be probably a day or two. But for everybody who's concerned about school, man, me and my family is good. Shouts out to all my family. We are good now here. Yeah. And as you can see, I'm at my physical therapy. Shit's back on. That was a little good 2-day break. Ida came in, did what she had to do, and now she gone. But I'm at physical therapy, so that means we're gonna be doing our scooter thing sometime this week, probably tomorrow, depending on how I feel. So y'all just stay tuned. I'm gonna have some footage of me on that scooter thing. You already know how it is. We all stay tuned, just checking in and letting everybody know that everything is everything. No more wind, rain, water, none of that. It's back to being a regular day. So, my brothers, sisters, nieces, nephews, y'all on trip. Everything is good. Sun out, no more wind, no more rain.
Woke up this morning. It was dark outside. There's a goddamn fire in the backyard. Check it out.
From over here. Oh, I see it. Who was that?